this video, we will show you how to connect WaferPro Express to the instruments and then to the Velox Prober control software. The first step is to establish GPIB connection to the network analyzer and the B1500 DC analyzer. From the hardware connections window, we add a new interface, which we call by name. In this case, it is GPIB0. Next, we have WaferPro Express look for all the instruments that are connected to this interface. We happen to know that the network analyzer is at address 16 and the B1500 is at address 17. To save time, I won't do an exhaustive search from 0 to 31. Eventually, it finds both instruments and populates the options. We physically connected the medium power SMU to port 1, or the gate side of the device, and the high power SMU to port 2, or the drain side of the device. We need to make sure the software knows about these connections. VG and VD are referenced by SMU1 and SMU2 in the WaferPro Express measurement routines. So under hardware connections, we may rename MPSMU as SMU1 and HPSMU as SMU2. We will now synchronize the network analyzer options on the actual network analyzer with those in the mind of WaferPro Express. This is done using the hardware connections window and selecting the PNAX active instrument. After clicking the Set VNA button, we set the start and stop frequency, number of points, and send the measurement setup to the VNA. But besides the measurement setup, all the instrument settings are sent to the PNA, including sweep mode, port powers, and coupling. The PNA is now ready for calibration. Next, we need to hook up WaferPro Express to the prober station, which is controlled by Cascade Microtech software, Velox. To do this in Velox, we launch the WaferSync server program. This is a special interface that enables communication between Velox and WaferPro Express. It advises turning off your computer's firewall. When we select the Velox prober system, it makes a connection to the Cascade server. Let's try making a connection. It's having a problem because the Windows firewall is causing issues. By allowing WaferPro Express to communicate on private and public networks, we are able to connect WaferPro Express to the Velox API. We may now verify connectivity by running some basic commands. For example, initialize setup, start prober, and go to home die. When I click probe contact, the chuck is raised and the probe makes contact. Let's bring the microscope back into focus. With the probe separate command, the chuck is lowered again. In this video, we demonstrated how to establish a connection between WaferPro Express and various instruments, and then another connection between WaferPro Express and our prober control software. You may check out other videos in this series for further useful demonstrations, like how to do wafer alignment and on-wafer RF calibration or WaferPro Express project setup.